is something that we started in 2003, beginning in Nigeria, and now this work has expanded in 17 countries across Africa. I'm really overcome with joy to see what has happened in Ghana. I clearly remember the day in 2012 when we came here in Accra and met with the ministry officials as well as with the Environmental Protection Agency to introduce the technology and talk to them about the potential of this technology, the Aflasafe biocontrol technology, on how it can reduce the burden of aflatoxin in Ghana. We were very happy to be received the way we were received. All the research institutions, they welcomed us and they wanted us to start the initiative. So we initially worked with the department, with KNUST, the university here, and recruited a student, Daniel, and along with MOFA, we began development of the strains of Aflasafe, and later on we started testing the Aflasafe strains in farmers' field with very encouraging results. The results were fantastic. In some cases, we were amazed that the amount of aflatoxin reduction that Aflasafe could do in both maize and groundnut was almost like 100%. And this is something that we didn't think it was going to happen, but over 2 years period and in hundreds of farmers' field, we could demonstrate that this particular product was effective. As an institution, IITA, we don't just believe in research per se, but we believe that the research that we do must benefit people. And therefore, we have made this effort to take this technology from our lab into the farmer's field and through this Aflasafe technology transfer and commercialization project. We are so heartened to see the amount of support from various stakeholders that we are receiving. And this initiative can only succeed if we have support from all stakeholders. And we are really happy to see that is actually happening. And all the best to Aflasafe GH02. And whoever takes it and markets it and manufactures it in Ghana, this is going to benefit the lives of Ghanaian people and the economy of Ghana.